Students, in our last video, I discussed with you about the Khilafat movement, the Satyagraha, as well as Rowlatt Act also. You remember well that the Rowlatt Act was passed hurriedly, and it was giving immense power to the British government. That is the reason Indians were not satisfied with the Rowlatt Act, and that's why they decided to boycott it. Not only the common men, but the main political party of that time, that was Indian National Congress, that also decided to oppose the Rowlatt Act, that was called Black Rule, or means Kala Kanun also. The main reason that the British government could crush the national freedom movement that was being launched against the British government. Though the people all over the nation were fighting for the nation's freedom, but at that time Punjab was the main center of the national freedom struggle, and in Punjab, especially Amritsar, was the main center of Indian independence movement. In Punjab, there were two prominent leaders in Punjab who were known as Dr. Saifuddin Kichlu and Dr. Satyapal. They were fighting in Amritsar and awakening the people to rise or to raise against the British government. Mahatma Gandhi urged the people to oppose the Rowlatt Act, but in non-violent way. In Amritsar, on 13 April 1919, a meeting was called in JalianWala Bagh to oppose the Rowlatt Act. JalianWala Bagh, now at present time it is in the main city, but that time it was out of city, as well as it is very close to the holy shrine, the Golden Temple. And you remember 13 April, we Indians celebrate this day as the Baisakhi festival in Punjab and Haryana especially. So the people of Punjab, they had come in Amritsar to offer their prayer in the Golden Temple. Seeing the festival very close, the British government imposed martial law in Amritsar. The administration of Amritsar was handed over to a military officer, General Neil O. Dyer. And he was called a very strict officer in British Army. A few days before the 13th April, he marched in the city to create terror among the people. And the leaders in Amritsar, Satyapalji and Saifuddin Kichluji, they were arrested and they were sent to some unknown place. Still, the meeting was called in Jallianwala Bagh, and message of both the leaders were read to the people who had assembled there. The meeting was going on in a peaceful manner. As it was the day of Baisakhi, so a number of people all over Punjab, they had come in Amritsar to offer their prayer at Golden Temple, And many of them, after saying their prayer, were having a rest in the Jallianwala Bagh. Meanwhile, the news reached to General Dyer, and he took his policemen and army men. If you had visited, then you know that there is a narrow passage to go or to enter in the Jallianwala Bagh. Now it has changed a lot, but that time there was only a narrow passage to enter or exit that bagh. General Dyer blocked the only passage, and without any warning, he ordered his troops to open fire on the crowd. That time, in that Jallianwala Bagh, a number of people were present there, including women and children also. And when the fire was opened, there was a big tremble. People started running here and there, and many of them were killed. Many of them jumped into the well that was present there. It is still in existence there, but now it has been covered. And it is now called Shahidi Kuwa or Martyr's Well. So many of people tried to survive them, tried to save their lives. And the walls surrounding that Jallianwala Bagh are so high that it could not be jumped over. It could not be crossed. So many people were killed. Even today, you can see the marks of bullet there. If you get a chance to visit that place, you must visit. It is a very holy place for Indians. Not for Hindus or Muslims, for Indians. Because it is a big place connected to our national freedom struggle. It is assumed that 1600 round bullets were used. Now you can imagine how many people were killed due to this firing. So this incident also enraged Indians. Mahatma Gandhi sent a delegation to the Jallianwala Bagh in Punjab. The British government claimed near about 100 or 150 persons were killed in this massacre. But the Congress delegation told that near about 2000 or 2500 people were killed in this massacre. So this incident is known as Jallianwala Bagh massacre. Massacre that literally means mass killing. Massacre means mass killing. So number of people were killed in this, and after that the British government started taking revenge, and they forced the people to crawl on the roads, and many people were asked to salute each and every British officer whomever they see on the road. So this was the cruelty of British government. After this incident, Indian National Congress decided to launch a mass movement against the British government. You remember, this incident happened in 13 April 1919, and 1920, Indian National Congress decided to launch a movement. In December 1920, a resolution was passed in the Indian National Congress session, And in 1921, this movement was launched. The movement unfolded in three steps. First, in rural areas. Second, in urban areas. And third, in plantations. So we will study it one by one. First, in rural areas. You know well that till then Mahatma Gandhi had left a good impression among the people. He had become very popular after the grand success of Satyagraha in South Africa. So Indian people had great expectations from Mahatma Gandhi. And in rural areas, on appeal of Mahatma Gandhi, the villagers followed his instructions with open heart. Mahatma Gandhi said that it is a non-cooperation movement, so that means we need not to cooperate with the British government. People need not to pay revenues to the British government. And all over India, people should disobey the British rules. So, following his instructions, the people in rural areas, they refused to pay revenue to the British government. Even the people who had relations with British persons, British officers, they were also boycotted. Even washermen refused to wash the clothes of such people. Cobblers refused to mend their shoes. In same way, at all level, each and every level, non-cooperation started against the British government. Even Nai Band, Dhobi Band, etc. Many incidents which were showing non-cooperation with the British government were launched. Now we come to second point, that is in urban areas. In urban areas, people participated in this movement enthusiastically. The students boycotted the British schools or government schools. People who were doing government service, they resigned from their jobs. Teachers resigned from their jobs. And even lawyers, they boycotted the British courts. A bonfire was started all over India. The foreign goods were collected and were set on fire at a common place, like squares. Mahatma Gandhi said that British had come to India only for trade purpose. They wanted to earn profits from the Indians. But if we start purchasing their goods, it will not be more beneficial for the Britishers. So they will have to leave India. And on appeal of Mahatma Gandhi, in urban areas also, people participated in the movement. So I think now you have understood how did people participate in this movement. Even a woman also participated in the movement. They started picketing. Let me clear you, picketing. Picket means this is like dharna. They used to sit. They used to sit before the shops where foreign goods were sold. And they started urging people not to purchase the foreign goods or the British goods. They appealed the people to buy only Indian goods. In this way, the movement got progress. Now, the third step, that was plantations. Movement at plantations. You remember, the northeast area, especially Assam, which was famous for tea plantations, and in south, Kerala and Tamil Nadu, which was famous for plantation of rubber. But here we will talk about plantation in Assam. A number of people from Odisha, Bihar and West Bengal, they worked at the plantations in Assam, and that were plantations were of tea plantations. The people worked there. Everyone translated the message of Mahatma Gandhi according to him. In this way, in Northeast, the workers took it as Gandhian age, Gandhi Yug. They took the message as Gandhi Yug is coming, and Mahatma Gandhi has promised to provide land in the native village. Therefore, they left the plantations, they disobeyed the orders of their owners and started for their villages. Unfortunately, when they reached near a river, which could be crossed only through steamers, but due to appeal of Mahatma Gandhi, these steamers were also on strike. So, they could not cross that river, and they were caught by they were arrested by the British police. Many of them ran away and took shelter in the forests nearby. And whenever they got opportunity, they came out and managed to reach their villages. But they did not return to the plantations. In this way, the people participated in the movement, and in my last meeting with you, I told you Mahatma Gandhi had urged the people not to be violent. But an incident that enraged the people when the movement was at peak. Meanwhile, an incident took place. Before this incident, Mahatma Gandhi had been arrested and he was put in Yerwada prison, which is situated in Pune in Maharashtra, which we call Pune. That time it was known as Pune. So Gandhiji was in prison, but in Uttar Pradesh there is a city, Gorakhpur. In Gorakhpur there is a village, Chori Chora, where the peasants of some villages had gathered and they were protesting the British government in a peaceful manner. But the British police lathi charged and many of them were beaten bitterly. So, that time the farmers returned to their places, but on the same day, in evening, they gathered and they surrounded the police station. They set free their companions who were farmers, and the policemen which were on duty in the jail or at Thana, they were locked in the building and the building was set on fire. So 22 policemen were burnt alive, and this incident took place in 1922. When this news reached to Gandhiji, who was in Yerwada prison. He was shocked and he decided to withdraw this movement, and in this way the non-cooperation movement come to end. So it was non-cooperation movement. Now I'm giving you some questions. One, in which year the non-cooperation movement begin? Number two, in which year the non-cooperation movement ended? Three, in which year the Jallianwala Bagh massacre took place? Next, you have to write a description on Jallianwala Bagh massacre, and you have to collect at least two pictures of Jallianwala Bagh. And next is, you have to write a note on non-cooperation movement. Thank you. See you in next lecture.